Well, that's a subject we could stay on for a long, long time, but I'd like to move on since we have a short amount of time left and several things I wanted to cover, and we're not going to make them all, of course. I'd like to talk for a moment about term limits. It seems that every year there's a term limit bill comes up, and there's pros and cons on both sides. There are arguments for term limits and arguments against them. And right now, what I'm doing basically is kind of moving into governmental structural changes. Think of term limits, amendment of the Constitution by referendum. Think of a unicameral legislature and so on for a minute.
Want to start here?
Yes, sir.
I'm for term limits. I'm for a unicameral legislature. I'm for the people having the, as Governor Hammond mentioned, the input to amend the Constitution. I think, number one, term limits and session lengths. I think that'll bring more people in. There's not an awful lot of people can afford to go down there for four and a half months a year. And I think if the sessions were shorter, and the limits were there, and I think in this unique owner state where we have to manage and regulate, a unicameral legislature would be the way to go. You bring it into one house, and you don't divide it, you bring it together. Those three I'm for.
Governor Hickel, opponents say that if you have term limits, mm-hmm. you're going to have the bureaucrats and the legislative age running the place because you don't have any legislators with the experience to do it.
Not as long as I'm alive.
My answer would be they do anyway.
Governor Cooper.
Yeah, I think that we ought to have term limits. Governors have term limits. You can't have two in a row anyway. And I think legislators ought to be in the same pot. I would extend that to people in the U.S. Congress.
And you agree with Governor Hickel on the unicameral system?
I don't know whether that would cure anything or not. I remember that we had some years ago a referendum on it, and people said they wanted it, and so naturally nothing happened. But I do think that a citizen legislature is a positive good, that professional lawmakers in a legislature or elsewhere is not what this state ought to be all about.
Governor Sheffield.
I agree with term limits. You can be on both sides of some terms and things like that, but I basically agree with term limits. I also agree with shorter sessions. There's not a one of us here that wouldn't agree that they only ought to meet 30 days or 40 days. The worst thing in the world that can happen to any governor is have them come to town, you know. Even Governor Hammond wrote me once and said, I thought they ought to be advisory only. And I said, I've been here long enough to realize that, you know. I thought it was funny coming out of him. He was one, you know, but take a nice guy like me who never was there before, you know, and have to deal with that sort of problem. But I think term limits, shorter sessions, and we have some good legislators. We really do, and I think we don't pay them right either. I think we only pay them $20,000 or $24,000 a year, and some of them deserve more. Some of them deserve none, but I think that has to be ironed out as well.
How about amendment of the Constitution by referendum? Give us all a shot at it.
For the term limits?
No, for just amending the Constitution. I'm sort of switching gears here.
Oh, you want to go back to amending the Constitution again for a
while? Well, we haven't left it. These two gentlemen are in favor of it.
He's talking about amending the Constitution with initiative and referendum.
Are you off the term limits?
Pardon?
I didn't realize you were off the term limits.
I didn't either. We've been too long here.
With conditions, Governor Hammond?
Yeah, you bet. You got to get in your mind that those folk who go to Juneau are not venial imbeciles that are conniving to do things only for themselves and advance themselves politically. They're really good folk. They know idealistically what they ought to do. They get trapped in the system. That system being, well, I've got to concern myself with re-election. Everybody at this table has had people come to them from the legislature and say, man, I'd like to go with you, but I wouldn't dare. I'd never get re-elected. Before you do anything, talk about unicameralism or term limit, you've got to remove that major concern that places paramount re-election over the best interest of the state. How you do that, I used to think, well, we have maybe two or three terms in the House and two in the Senate. I have reached the conclusion that one six-year term, well, not lavishly, but well compensated for, with a degree of some substantive retirement, that would permit the average guy to leave his business back home without devastating himself when he gets out 6 years later, would give us a far better end product than what we see now. Because of the way the legislature is structured, where one arbitrary committee chairman can stymie the will of the body in the best interest of the state, you've got to restructure that concept or remove the concern for re-election, or you're going to be right back to square one.
Governor Miller, well, same I've question. Heard, term limits, unicameral legislature amendment to the Constitution,
all right,
by referendum.
I've got to have my say on term limits.
Okay.
I've heard all the arguments against term limits, and I'm still in favor of term limits. I think that the good that would come out of it outweighs any problem, and I know people say, well, the voters wouldn't get a chance to vote for somebody they wanted back in office after he'd been in the limit of his term. But I still think, on balance, that term limits are good. As far as the unicameral legislature is concerned, I have grave reservations about that. I realize that with two houses, it's, it comes totally to gridlock sometimes, but it might be too smooth with unicameral legislature. I don't know. It might, things might get through too fast without enough checks and balances. I know only one state in the United States, Nebraska, has a unicameral legislature, and they're a far different state from Alaska, so I'd have to be convinced on that subject. Now, as far as amending the Constitution by referendum, I certainly prefer that method of amending the Constitution to throwing it open to a convention. I would say that. If we're going to amend the Constitution, let's do it by referendum.
We have a short amount of time, and Governor Hammond, I'd like you to say what you want to say, and then I want to move to one more last.
I didn't say anything about the unicameralism. My concerns with unicameralism are what I mentioned before, that one arbitrary individual representing a special interest area or local constituency can stymie everybody else. Unless you were to elect them statewide so that they have to place paramount the concerns of everybody in the state, I don't think unicameralism is the way to go. And of course, that would compound the abuse of campaign rhetoric and TV advertising.
Oh. Gentlemen, this has been great. We have a minute and a half before I have to close this program. I'd like to give each of you, as I said earlier, and you know, somebody told me early, you know, we can't fill this time, but do you have anything you'd like to say in about 20 seconds, Governor Hickel?
20 seconds. Government's too important in Alaska, in this owner state, to keep beating it up. If you keep beating government up, you're not going to get the kind of people you want, and all they do is divide us up, and the economic interests, wherever they are, sort of take over. So just make it responsible, but just don't beat it up, because if you beat it up, you're not going to get anything.
Governor Cooper.
Well, I'd like to emphasize that I think that Alaska's in pretty good shape. We like to dwell on our problems, but we're pretty fortunate compared to most other states, and we can resolve the problems that are in front of us.
Governor Sheffield?
And Steve is right. I think we're in good shape. We've done a lot of things right. We've made some mistakes, but so does everybody else. I think that our future is bright. We have a lot of things that a lot of people need in the world, and we have a picturesque state and a lot of beauty, and I think we have a lot of great people, a lot of resourceful people. Everyone here loves it and wants to be here for the most part, and I think that we need to just enhance what we have. I think that the permanent fund is a basic structure, the foundation for the state. I think we ought not to tinker with it. Don't play with it. Don't try to change it. Don't fool with it. Leave it alone. And let it just build and build and build. And sometime we'll probably have to use it. And if we do, it'll be there. We'll be the only country in the world that ever kept it.
Thank you, sir. Governor Hammond, Governor Sheffield, cut in a little on your time. So
that's fine. I believe, as they do, that we're in good shape prospectively, but we best be very careful and recognize that the way we're going now, doing things to promote economic development that induces population increases without extracting enough from that increment in population can kill us. We have to make sure that those activities pay their way and the people that come up here and engage in them do. If we do that, we're in good shape. If we don't do it, right now, every municipality in the state is hurting. Why? Primarily because they don't recognize there are two economies. Private sector economy that flourishes under population increases. Public sector economy, government, i.e. furnishing services for that increment, that is killed by it. You've got to balance those two, and until we do so, we're going to start hurting.
Thank you, Governor Miller.
Well, you ask where we'd be in 17 years. I think basically Alaska will still be pretty much the way it is now. It will be a resource state. We can't count on the military to keep expanding and helping our economy, and we've got to again, as I keep saying, we've got to strike that balance between growth and development and protecting our environment.
Gentlemen, thank you very much. You know, there's no doubt that we Alaskans have some problems, and we have lots of challenges as the 21st century approaches, but I believe KUAC's done very well by us tonight by having you gentlemen here, and I really think it's been great. It's important that Alaskans continue to utilize the experience and the resource of those leaders who've been there in the past, who know what it's all about rather than just reading it in the newspaper. So on behalf of all Alaskans, particularly KUAC in Fairbanks, I warmly thank you, gentlemen, for all your contributions to Alaska, for joining us tonight. So thank you, Governor Walter J. Hickel, Governor Steve Cooper, Governor Bill Sheffield, Governor Jay Hammond, and Governor Keith Miller. Good night.
Thank you.